when the hair loss in the front has become unmanageable, there is no particular hairstyle that is, you know, that the patient is being able to use to cover the baldness, only then we offer a hair transplant to ladies. So hair loss primarily affects men. This is a myth. This is an old school thought, and now we are seeing more and more females having hair loss issues. Hello friends, my name is Dr. Gaurang Krishna, and today we will be talking about hair loss in women. We are seeing more and more ladies coming to us with the hair, different kinds of hair fall issues. So now we'll be discussing what exactly causes hair loss in ladies, what are different causes and different types of hair loss in ladies. As we've discussed, a fairly common problem, and the most common hair loss now in ladies is patterned hair loss, the thing that affects men. Same thing is affecting ladies also, and gradual hair thinning is very common in ladies. Second very common hair loss cause is the acute hair fall, which is also called as Silogen effluvium. We have discussed that in a separate video in the past, and we'll be discussing that in brief. Then ladies are prone to nutritional deficiencies, particularly iron deficiency, that may cause hair loss. Hypothyroidism is another very common cause of hair loss in ladies. And then there are certain not so common problems like chronic telogen effluvium, alopecia areata, medical causes of hair loss in ladies that we'll be touching on in brief. So let's talk about patterned hair loss in ladies, which is also called as female patterned hair loss, in detail. Now we all know that hair thinning affects men. You know, the male hormone attaches to the hair roots and causes hair thinning and gradually baldness. But not many people know that the same thing can affect ladies also. Ladies also may experience thinning of hair, gradually loss of volume, sparsening of the center parting, reduction in the volume of the plait. All this is called as female patterned hair loss, where the roots gradually thin out. Now, in men, the pathology is very well understood that it is because of the male hormone sensitivity. Whereas in ladies, the pathology is a bit ambiguous as of now. The most common accepted theory still is male hormone sensitivity, but there is new evidences which are pointing towards involvement of female hormones as well. But as I told you, this is a bit of a gray zone. So currently, the most accepted theory is male hormone sensitivity in ladies as well. So what happens is that in ladies who are genetically predisposed to sensitivity towards the male hormone, this little male hormone in their body, you know, attaches to the hair roots and causes a thing called miniaturization of hair roots, which manifests itself as hair thinning and gradual loss of volume. So this is the most common cause of hair loss in women as of now, patterned hair loss. Patterned hair loss has been, you know, graded into three types or three stages. Grade 1, where the thinning has just started, the, you know, patient lady has started experiencing some hair thinning, some loss of volume. Grade 2, when there is noticeable gap in the central parting. And grade 3, variable visibility of the scalp and near baldness, particularly in the front areas. That is characterized as grade 3. The management depends on the type or the stage of the problem. Unlike in men, where we do not investigate too much, in ladies, because there are so many causes of hair loss, we have to do a proper workup. The commonly used investigations are the hormonal profile, where we test for male and female hormones, the levels of it. We test for iron stores, the iron levels, the hemoglobin levels in the body. We rule out thyroid. We rule out other nutritional deficiencies via vitamin D and vitamin B12. That gives us an idea of the overall nutritional status. So after we have done a thorough workup and we identify the cause. So if there is a nutritional deficiency, a specific nutritional deficiency, that is corrected. If there is a hypothyroidism, that is corrected. And then if, of course, there is hormonal issues, they are separately taken care of. Now, if we find that everything is normal, then there's a clinical diagnosis of female pattern hair loss. So the treatment would depend on first the stage of hair loss and second, how concerned the patient is for her hair loss. Why this? Because there are two separate categories of treatment. One is hormonal, which is intensive or strong treatment, and one is non-hormonal, which is, which has a lesser effect but is generally, you know, by and large safe treatment. So in a lady who is experiencing early stages of hair loss or is not too concerned about her hair loss, then we try to be conservative in treatment and offer them non-hormonal treatments. The non-hormonal treatments are primarily minoxidil, which is an FDA approved treatment for hair loss. You know, it's now in many countries that's available over the counter as well, and almost everybody has heard of it. So what this lotion does, it increases blood flow and gradually, you know, balances your hair cycle and reduces your hair fall and gives you better hair over a long period of time. Secondly, other treatments, ancillary or let's say reinforcing treatments like PRP treatment is done. We give nutritional support via, you know, structured cyclical vitamin therapy. There is laser, you know, low level laser therapy, mesotherapy. There are so many options. So this is the non-hormonal treatment where we give minoxidil, nutritional support, PRP, mesotherapy, low level laser therapy, depending on what the patient wants and what the physician decides. This treatment is by and large safe, and particularly for ladies who are in the childbearing age, we try to offer them non-hormonal treatment only. When the hair loss is extensive or the lady is too worried about her hair problem, then along with the non-hormonal, we offer hormonal treatment as well. Hormonal treatment basically, as of now, are targeted towards anti-male hormone. So the effect of male hormone or the production of male hormone, we try to reduce that. This theory that in females also, the main culprit hormones are the male hormone. So our treatment is directed towards the male hormone rather than the female hormones. So there are certain medications, discussion of which is beyond the scope of this video. There are certain medications that we give after proper investigations and proper counseling, and the effect is usually good. One thing that we must understand is that in patterned hair loss, treatment is ongoing. There is no course. The treatment will be effective till you are doing it. So we start with hormonal, when we want to treat it aggressively, we start with hormonal and non-hormonal treatment, and after a couple of years we try to stop the hormonal treatment and continue with non-hormonal treatment to maintain that effect. The disclaimer here is that all this, particularly hormonal treatment, should be done only under a doctor's guidance, particularly by ladies who are in the childbearing potential, because the treatment being hormonal has a side effect profile as well. So it should not be taken lightly. So this is about patterned hair loss, medical part of it. Then hair transplant. Hair transplant in female patterned hair loss is not very common. You know, we have to move cautiously. So when do we offer hair transplant to ladies? It's primarily grade 3, when the hair loss in the front has become unmanageable. There is no particular hairstyle that is, you know, that the patient is being able to use to cover the baldness. Only then we offer a hair transplant to ladies. The ratio here is that in our practice, out of 150 to 200 male hair transplants that we do, then we do one female hair transplant. So that is the ratio, 1:200. That, you know, tells you that hair transplant is really the last resort that we go to when it comes to female pattern hair loss. The reason being, ladies don't get bald. There is no permanent, properly defined permanent zone. Shaving of the scalp is a big psychological and cultural barrier. Results are not so impressive as compared to what we get in men. So because of all these reasons, we tend to not do hair transplant very commonly in ladies. But when we do, we focus more on the front. We try to give the lady enough hair so that just to cover the frontal part, just to create that optical illusion of having some hair in the front. So hair transplant should not be seen as a very important part of management of female pattern hair loss, and only as a last resort when nothing else would work. Now coming to other common causes as acute hair fall or telogen effluvium. So we have discussed that in the past. So basically, telogen effluvium is seasonal hair loss, post-pregnancy hair loss, post-fever or illness hair fall. It is an acute hair fall where you lose a lot of hair, but treatment is usually not needed and you recover, you outgrow that condition. So that's about telogen effluvium. Nutritional deficiencies are common in ladies. So we supplement wherever we feel there is a nutritional deficiency somewhere. We supplement with vitamins like biotin, vitamin D, iron, etc. to improve the hair quality. And then there are certain less common hair fall or less common hair diseases in ladies like chronic telogen effluvium, where there's a problem in the hair cycle. The lady continue to lose 100 to 200 hair in a day, but then somehow the body replenishes as well. And in the long run, the reduction in volume is not that significant. There are scarring alopecia, which are proper medical conditions where the entire hair follicle and the skin is damaged by an inflammatory process. Again, treatment is primarily directed towards limiting the damage that the disease can do. And when the disease has burnt out and there are certain patches, that can be filled with a hair transplant as and when needed. So by and large, this is about female, the hair loss in females, which are commonly, the common types are female pattern hair loss, which is hormone dependent, and the acute seasonal or post-illness hair fall, which recovers also. So that is about female pattern hair loss. This is Dr. Gaurang Krishna. Thank you very much for seeing this video.